are here. The beautiful country here in Texas. So we will see you in a bit.
Joys of country roads in Texas. It's beautiful out here. Still recording. Okay, let's hit the road again. This is the country road. I got a CR-135. This might turn into gravel road, so let's see where it goes.
I lost a bit of audio in my mic there. So basically, I just saw some horses in a farm there. So I just stopped over and thought I'd just take some pictures and spend some time with them.
Upset with my antics.
Some gravel roads. I just stopped, changed the setting to the enduro mode, and then started riding. So basically, you know, the gravel road was a lot of fun. What you had to do was, again, just think like you have eggs in your hand, and then when you're holding your handlebars. But other than that, you know, you just keep your weight on the pegs, and then the bike moves around you. The biggest difference between sitting and standing and riding is that when you're sitting and riding, when the bike moves, you feel your weight shift with it, and you sometimes you actually work against it, because your instinctive reaction is to, you know, see what's going on there, because your body's moving a little bit, the backside actually. But when you're standing, the bike moves and you barely feel it, because you're on your pegs don't move at all. So it is really comfortable and convenient standing and riding on gravel, and it's 100 times better than sitting and riding. That's my experience. So if you guys go on gravel or any other off-road where you have to shift your weight around, the bike moves, probably even in sand and other places too, but you have to just stand and ride. I think that's the easiest way to handle this. So it's a lot of fun, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. I'm going to follow it here again next week. You see, there were some more gravel roads on the sides which I wanted to tackle. You see me sitting down here just to change the gear, because I was, I think, in third, and then I came down here and I wanted to come back to second for the curve. You know, maybe next time I'll take it in third. But it was a lot of fun. You've probably seen me doing the same thing here when I finished the curve. But it was a lot of fun. The bike just performed like magic, and it just made me look like a great rider, but it's all the bike. I had some difficulties. I think the mic from my helmet, the connection, I lost it somewhere in the middle, because for some reason the camera kept switching off after recording for about 10 seconds. Then I figured out maybe the button in the casing was bothering it and making it switch off. So I had to stop and fiddle around with it. I hope you enjoy the video.